الحمد لله الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور انفسنا ومن سيئات اعمالنا اما بعد والسابقون الاولون من المهاجرين والانصار والذين اتبعوهم باحسان رضي الله عنهم ورضوا عنه واعد لهم جنات تجري تحتها الانهار خالدين فيها ابدا ذلك الفوز العظيم صدق الله العظيم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي سبحانك لا علم لنا الا ما علمتنا انك انت العليم الحكيم السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته It's nice to have all the brothers back again. Our today's hero, inshallah, comes all the way from Persia. And his name is Salman al-Farsi, radiallahu ta'ala. Salman the Persian. Hazrat Salman, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he has a very adventurous and a fascinating story to how he had embraced the religion of Islam. And how he had abandoned the religion of his Persian people for Christianity. And how he had come then after this to Islam. And how he had shunned and abandoned the wealth and estate of his father. And he just threw himself into the arms of the wilderness in search for release from his tension and in search for the truth. And then after this, how he meets over the group of Jews and how they sell him as a slave to some other Jews. And after this, how he comes to meet the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and embraces Islam. Hazrat Salman radiallahu ta'ala an, he was the most beloved of his father's sons, who was a fire worshipper and a figure of very high esteem amongst his people. Now when Hazrat Salman radiallahu ta'ala an, when he also grew up, he devoted his whole life to worshipping fire. And to the point where he became a custodian of this fire which they had lit, and which they would never ever allow anyone to actually extinguish. One day Hazrat Salman's father, who had an estate, he sent Hazrat Salman radiallahu ta'ala to this estate. And whilst he's on his way, he goes past a church from which he can hear the noise of some people praying. So Hazrat Salman radiallahu ta'ala, curious, he peeks inside and he sees these people praying. And he's impressed by what he sees in these people's prayer. So he goes and he sits down. To the extent that the sun begins setting, and he hasn't been to his father's estate, nor has he returned back home. So being the most beloved son, Hazrat Salman's father, he sends out a search party. And they bring him back home. Hazrat Salman radiallahu ta'ala, when he gets home, he begins questioning his father regarding the religion that they are on. And after seeing his father's frustration because of not being able to answer the question, he tells his father and he informs him of this new religion that he has seen and that he is impressed. Hazrat Salman's father radiallahu ta'ala, Allahu Akbar, he's taken back by shock. And what he does is, because he's scared that Hazrat Salman is going to leave the religion of his forefathers, he imprisons him and he puts him into shackles. Hazrat Salman radiallahu ta'ala, whilst he's in these shackles, he writes a letter to the people, the Christians, informing them that he's embraced their religion and that if a caravan comes from Syria, he should be informed. One day he receives a letter from the Christians telling him that they are very happy regarding him embracing their religion, and soon a caravan should be coming from Syria. When the caravan arrives, Hazrat Salman radiallahu ta'ala, by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he breaks free from the shackles and he goes with this caravan and he goes to Syria. On reaching Syria, he asks regarding the most knowledgeable person of the Christian religion in Syria. So that they inform him about the bishop. Hazrat Salman radiallahu ta'ala, he goes to the bishop and he stays in the bishop's service. And there he learns from the bishop and he prays alongside with the bishop. But he comes to realize that this bishop, he's not very faithful to his religion. And what he does is, he collects the charity from the people and he uses it for his own purposes, his own necessities. This person, he's not very faithful to his religion. So after, when this person is on his deathbed, Hazrat Salman radiallahu ta'ala, he looks for another person. And he waits whilst this person he dies, and after he dies, the leader who takes over this person, Hazrat Salman radiallahu ta'ala, he approaches this person and he stays in his service. And he realizes that this person, he is the most God-fearing person that he ever knows. Until this person's death, Hazrat Salman radiallahu ta'ala, he stays with this monk, or you can call him a bishop. He stays with him and he worships and he learns more and more, and his knowledge is increasing regarding his religion. When the time for this person's death he comes, Hazrat Salman radiallahu ta'ala, he asks him for a recommendation. That who shall I go to after you pass away? This person, he says to him that I swear by Allah that I don't know anybody on my path except for one person who lives in a place called Musil. After this monk, he passes away, Hazrat Salman radiallahu ta'ala, he goes now to the third monk. And there he stays with the third monk, he's living his life, he's learning more knowledge, his knowledge is increasing and he's worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When the time for this monk's death comes, Hazrat Salman, he also asks him for a recommendation. Now who do you think I should go to? So this monk, he sends him to a place called Nasibin. And in Nasibin, he says that there'll be this monk and he describes him. After this monk, he dies, he goes to Nasibin and he stays with this fourth monk. Hazrat Salman radiallahu ta'ala, like this, he's growing up and his knowledge of Christianity is increasing, and he stays with this person, his piety, Allahu Akbar, is increasing. Until also, you know, by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, the death of this fourth person, it comes closer. So he asks him for a recommendation. That who would you recommend me to go to? So this monk, he also tells him, that he says to him, there's a place called Amuria, it's a place in Rome. He says to him, that by Allah, nobody on the face of earth exists on my path apart from this one person who lives in Amuria. Go with him and stay in his service. Hazrat Salman radiallahu ta'ala, like the person he recommended, he goes to Amuria, a place in Rome, and he stays there with this last person. This is the final person that he stays with. When this person's death, it approaches close, Hazrat Salman radiallahu ta'ala, he asks him for a recommendation. That who would you recommend me to go to after you pass away? He says to him that by Allah, then no one remains on my path who can lead you on the right, who can lead you to the right way, to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But I can tell you one thing, that you are living in such a time, you are living in such a time in which a person who is going to come, who's going to claim to be a prophet, he is going to be on the pure creed of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. This person, he will eat from something that has been given to him as a gift, but he will never eat from charity. And if you look, he will have the seal of prophethood between his two shoulder blades. Seeing this monk, he passes away. Hazrat Salman radiallahu ta'ala, he's weighing. One day, a caravan goes past and is heading towards Arabia. Hazrat Salman radiallahu ta'ala, he makes a deal with these people. That I've got some goats, I've got some sheep, I'll give you these if you can take me to Arabia. When these people, they take him to Arabia, as soon as he gets to Arabia, these people, they deceive him. And what they do is they take him to a slave market. And in the slave market, they sell him off to a Jewish person. Without him even knowing, Hazrat Salman radiallahu ta'ala, he's being sold as a slave to a Jewish person. This Jewish person, he takes him back. And when the place that he takes him, Hazrat Salman radiallahu ta'ala, he's taken by shock. Allahu Akbar. There's many palm trees. And this is also one of the signs that this last monk had told him about. That the place that he is going to migrate to will be full and there will be many, many palm trees. When Hazrat Salman radiallahu ta'ala, he sees this, he thinks that this is the place and he's full of joy. He's full of joy and he's pleased and he thinks that this is the place where this final prophet is going to come. But obviously it wasn't. Anyway, he stays with this Jew for a short while and he works for him. He stays in his service and he's practicing the religion that he was taught by the last monk. Now one day, this Jew that he was with, who was his master, he sells him off to another Jew from the tribe of Banu Qurayza, which was in Madinatul Munawwara. He says that as soon as this second Jew, he bought me and he took me and I entered Madinatul Munawwara, he says when I seen the amount of palm trees, he says that I knew straight away Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put it inside my heart that this is the place where the last prophet is going to come. He says that I stayed there for a long time working for this second Jew until one day, he says that I was on top of a tree taking down fruit, and beneath the tree was my master. And all of a sudden, somebody came from a far distance, running towards my master, saying to him that may Allah subhanahu, may Allah, he curse the people of Quba. So he asks him that, why are you so angry? What made you so frustrated? So he tells him, he says that these people are spreading a rumor regarding someone who has migrated from Makkah al-Mukarramah and he has come to Madinah al-Munawwarah and there he is claiming that he is a prophet. He says, as soon as I heard this, I jumped off the tree asking him that repeat what you have said, repeat what you have said. He says, my master, he turned around and he gave me a nasty slap, saying to me that this doesn't have anything to do with you, get back to work. He says, I got back to work, but as soon as night fell, he says, I gathered everything that I had and I went in search of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When he got into the service of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said that everything I had, I presented in front of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, saying to him that I know that you have traveled from far, you may be hungry, take this as charity. He said the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he called the companions and he told them to eat, but he himself, he didn't eat. He said, when I seen this, I realized that this is the first sign. Then he says, I went away, the next day I came back again and I had some more food. This time I said to him that I have realized that you didn't eat from charity. This is a gift. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he called the companions that were sitting around and he told them to eat and he also joined them himself. He said that when I seen this, these were two signs that the final monk, he had told me about. He says that one day I was sitting when I seen the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam returning from a journey. He says that I went and I met him and I hugged him. And he says that slowly I looked over his shoulder to see if the seal of prophethood was there. It was as if the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam knew what he was looking for. He moved his garment to show him, here, have a look. He says, when I seen this, I hugged the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and began crying to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And there he embraced Islam in front of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Now, after this, we have to remember that Hazrat Salman radiallahu ta'ala, he was still a slave, which prevented him from taking part in the battle of Uhud, in the battle of Badr, and because of something that he was quite upset about, he felt let down that he couldn't assist the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in these battles. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he seen this grief and he advised Hazrat Salman radiallahu ta'ala that you can go into terms with your master and you can be free. When Hazrat Salman radiallahu ta'ala, he goes into terms with his master, the rest of the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they help Hazrat Salman radiallahu ta'ala and to fulfill this promise that he had made and to free him from his master. Allahu Akbar, the companions, rahama'u bainahum, that they are living amongst each other, they all helped him and they freed him from his master. You know, this was, you know, Allahu Akbar, this was his story of how he had embraced Islam. One day he was sitting with he was living in the house of Hazrat Abu Darda radiallahu ta'ala, another companion that inshallah soon we'll be talking about. He was sitting with Hazrat Abu Darda radiallahu ta'ala, and it was the habit of Hazrat Abu Darda that all night he would pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and throughout the day he would stay hungry and he would fast. Now, because of this, he would sort of slack in fulfilling some of the rites.